following several big stories tonight, where we begin with the Indianapolis City Councilor who is under investigation again. Multiple sources confirmed to Eyewitness News that Jeff Miller violated a no-contact order connected to his child molestation case.
Now, we were the very first to break this story just hours ago when we sent you a push alert on our WTHR app. Our news reporter tonight, Emily Longnecker, is live with what Miller allegedly did tonight that had police ready to arrest him yet again. Emily.
Well, John and Andrea, multiple sources tell Eyewitness News that this is the spot where Indianapolis Councilman Jeff Miller showed up for a Fletcher Place Neighborhood Association meeting tonight. The problem, Miller has a no-contact order to stay away from the families of his alleged victims. And according to multiple sources, three people on that list were also at tonight's meeting. Now, Miller reportedly stayed at the meeting even after realizing some people on the no-contact list were there. An off-duty police officer called dispatch, which could not readily confirm the no-contact information. Now, during that time, Miller reportedly refused to leave. By the time the no-contact order was confirmed and uniformed officers were on their way, Miller had taken off. Since his arrest on multiple child molestation charges, Miller has shown up to a council meeting and multiple community meetings like the one tonight. Miller has said he won't step down from council, but despite multiple calls for him to resign, we knocked on Miller's door tonight to get some answers, but no one came to the door. Now, we also spoke tonight with Fletcher Place Neighborhood Association President Andy Howard. We talked to him on the phone. Howard told me that he was unaware of any no-contact order that Miller was under. Howard said that Jeff Miller is from the Fletcher Place neighborhood and is frequently at meetings and has been a member in good standing. John?
All right, thank you. Emily Longnecker reporting tonight. Now, one of Miller's fellow counselors says the situation with Miller appears to now be a drain on resources. Scott Kreider tweeted, in part, he's entitled to the presumption of innocence, but as feared, service under the cloud of this case is a distraction to real issues and creates potential conflicts. Miller was stripped of his three committee assignments on the council, and one of those committees is set to meet this week.